How do I know if an intervention is evidence-based? Why would I look at study quality and results?
So let's start quickly by saying, what is an evidence-based intervention? It's a treatment or an intervention that we know is effective, and we know it's effective because we've implemented that procedure faithfully. Technically, when we speak about the faithfulness of an intervention, we're speaking about the fidelity of intervention. And that means, really simply, that what procedure you put in place was actually done the way it should be done. That's critical because if you don't do it the right way, you can have either one of two outcomes. One outcome is that an otherwise effective intervention is shown to be ineffective, and then people draw the wrong conclusions about the effectiveness of the intervention. Or, in fact, it could appear as if it's effective when, in fact, the reason why some change took place, an improvement or a reduction in a behavior, was because there was some other factor associated with the treatment that was responsible for the outcome. That's called a confounding variable, and we want to do everything we possibly can to ensure that those confounds are removed. So we can be sure that when we say a treatment or an intervention is effective, it actually is. We have to be sure that we can measure an outcome that's relevant to what it is that we're interested in. And we have to be sure that the measures that we choose that reflect changes in some outcome that we're concerned about are both reliable and valid. And the reliability dimension simply means that that measure will yield consistent results when we administer the measure. We don't get changes in the instrument that we're using to measure, but also that it's relevant, that it actually reflects the idea or the outcome that we're concerned about. That's really at a core what validity is. Now, many of you have, I'm sure, been involved in a situation in which you had an intervention, you implemented the intervention, and you saw a change in the outcome, and you'd like to be able to attribute the change to the intervention that you used. Maybe you did this in a classroom or you did it with a child. It would make sense that you could measure the outcome of interest, implement the intervention, and then measure the outcome again to see if there was a change in the outcome that you were interested in. And it would make sense that you would attribute that change to the intervention that you used. Technically speaking, in our procedures associated with NCII, the National Center for Intervention, that's not enough. It's not enough just to show that an outcome changed because you implemented it. And the reason is that it can be that an outcome changed, say, after an intervention because of some confounding variable, some other variable. So, for example, one of the factors that could make a difference is that some of the participants who had a certain kind of behavioral profile at the beginning were dropped from the study, and as a result, the outcome changes when you measure the group, but in fact, the behavior of the group would not have changed if you had included those participants in. Or, say, kids change, right? They develop, and so things can improve or they can get worse because of some maturational process. The way we take care of that situation is through what random assignment of participants to an intervention condition, and then to compare the performance of another group, a control group, who doesn't get the intervention or gets a comparison intervention. We randomly assign participants to those conditions. We measure them prior to the intervention. We then implement the intervention as well as the comparison condition, and then we measure on the outcome. And if, in fact, a difference exists under those conditions, we can be reasonably confident that the result that we would like to take as evidence of the effectiveness of the intervention is, in fact, attributable to the intervention. So I guess in what I'd like to say is that, kind of in summing this up, that we need results, but having a result without having certain conditions in place will not allow us to be certain that the intervention is responsible for the outcome. We need to have, ideally, we need to have random assignment of participants to conditions, comparison conditions, as well as the intervention condition, so we can see if the intervention is truly responsible for the change. Ideally, we would like to have both measures before the intervention, relevant measures, as well as after, to be sure that the groups are comparable at before the intervention, but differ at the end as a result of the intervention. We want to be sure that the measures we choose are both reliable and valid. If we put those conditions in place, we can be more confident that the outcome that we're interested in really is attributable to the intervention.